Black belts, tell me I'm wrong. That's the thing. People sometimes say when they find out I do karate and I'm a black belt, and they say, oh, you're a black belt, you must be really good. And I respond with, no, I'm a black belt, which means I'm really crap. Because whether we like it or not, we develop labels for ourselves as a black belt. I'm not good at kicks. Crap, you just never gone through the failure to get good at kicks. Like for myself, when I kick, I use them sparingly. Most of it's hands, and occasionally I bring a kick out. But that's because I know I can score with a kick. So what I'll do is that I'll set the kick up and I'll do hands, and so they're starting to read the play, and then I'll sneak a kick out because I know it can work. But that's now. Before, if you took video footage of me when I'm a Shodan Ho and a brown belt and a red belt and a blue belt, you will see a person kicking a million times in Kumite, because I understood that I had to fail 99 times out of 100 to eventually get to a point where I can score 60 or 70% of the time. So when you're not the best kicker in the dojo, you should be the person kicking the most. I should look around a room and see that person kick, 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 and that person kick, 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 and this person kick, 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 and they're the ones who are the worst at kicks. And don't listen to someone if they say, oh, you shouldn't kick so much because you're not really good at them, because you don't need a critic like that. You need a coach, and you should be your best coach. And you should know as a coach that every time you kick and you fail and you kick and you fail and you kick and you fail, then you're getting closer to success, because eventually you'll get the speed and that will give you confidence, and you'll develop the timing from doing it a million times. You'll develop the right timing. You'll know what kick to do at what situation and how to set it up, and things will come to you. You know, labels people have. I'm no good at counterattacking. Crap, you've just never practiced enough. You've never been willing to take the hits to get good at it. I'm no good at sweeping. How often do you practice? How often do you, have you just got a bag there, a training bag, and you're kicking it? You're sweeping your training bag, or putting shoes on and sweeping a pole, what I like to do. How many times are you doing that sort of stuff? People say, oh, I'm no good at the goju kata, I'm more the shotokan kata, the sharper kata. That's a load of garbage, because you've just never devoted the time to those kata. You've focused so much on one and labeled yourself as good at this and not good at another, and so you don't give it the time. And even if you do give it the time, because you've told yourself, like, maybe I'm not really good at the slower kata because they've got the fluency. I like the snap, because when you've got the slower moves, I don't necessarily have the finesse. But that's because you're thinking about, I'm a snappy person, I'm a snappy person. And if you actually understand that, it will tell yourself, you know what? I have beautiful fluency, I have beautiful movement. Just that mindset alone will actually improve the quality of your movement. I love Will Smith's quote where he says, skill is developed by beating and beating and beating on your craft. And that's how it's done. That's why most of you are comfortable with the things you're comfortable on, because those things you're doing most inspiring, you've probably done a million times. I mean, most people are pretty comfortable with their reverse punch, because every class we're just constantly punching, punching, punching. You've literally, it's not because that's what's natural to you, you've just done it 10 times more than anything else. So if you want to develop new skill sets, you want to develop some evasion, some sweeps, some fancy kicks, some pick-off techniques, pick-off hands, pick-off feet, you know, block counter with the same hand. You want to develop these different things. You've got to just simply put in the hours, and the results will come. But if you label yourself, you'll never get there, because you'll never do the work, because you'll have apathy. You'll think, what's the point? I'm no good at that. What's the point? Because that's not who I am. So you've got to be willing to give up who you are to become who you want to become.